Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Hello dear students, I am Dr. Mona Simulty from HNB Garhwal University, Srinagar, Garhwal. Welcome you all in this module, and today in this module we are going to discuss the common diseases of oral cavity, their symptoms, their causes and their treatment. So let us start this module, and these are our learning outcome. Different types of diseases associated with the oral cavity. So after going through from this module, you will come to know different types of diseases, underlying causes, okay, symptoms associated with the disease, and preventive and treatment measures. So lesson plan. So this lesson plan we are going to follow. First, we will see the list of diseases of oral cavity, which are very commonly common diseases, okay, their underlying causes, what are different symptoms. We will discuss their symptoms and prevention measures and treatment. So dear students, common diseases of oral cavity. There are number of diseases of oral cavity, but here in this module we will discuss common diseases which we observe in the patients. Okay, so these are like tooth decay, okay, periodontal disease, thrush and trench mouth, dry mouth, okay, it's hepatic gingivostomatitis and mumps, mouth ulcer, okay, tooth erosion and staining of the teeth, cavity formation, and hyperodontia, that is the extra teeth, sometimes it's there in the oral cavity. And so these are few diseases of oral cavity. So let's see them one by one. Quickly we will see, so because there are number of diseases. So let us start with the first one, tooth decay. Okay, so tooth decay is also known as dental caries, okay, or cavity, which is very common in the kids of below 10 year age. We generally call that there is a cavity in his teeth because the kids, they generally eat lot of sweets, chocolates. Okay, so cavity, it is a breakdown of teeth due to the acid made by bacteria. Okay, the cavity may be a number of different colors, from yellow to black. Okay, the most common bacteria associated with the dental cavities are mutans and streptococci. Okay, and streptococci, mutans and streptococcus sabrinus, and so, and lactobacilli. So these are the bacteria which produces acid in the tooth, so that's why it starts little degrading and it may vary from yellow to black color. So this is about the tooth decay. Okay, so common disease of oral cavity, in this etiology of this accumulation of food particles, accumulation of bacteria in the gelatinous mass, aerobic fermentation of sugar in the saliva, and release of lactic acid. So this is about tooth decay etiology and precautions which we need to prevent. This thing is low sugar consumption and low fluoride and proper brushing only. Okay, next is periodontal disease. Periodontal disease is a serious gum infection. Okay, it is really serious gum infection that damages the soft tissue and it destroys the bone that support the teeth. Okay, so periodontal disease can cause teeth to loosen and lead to the tooth loss completely. So it is a common disorder, but largely it is preventable and it is caused by Porphyromonas streptococcus. Okay, so here first let me tell you about the different types of periodontal disease, gingivitis. Okay, most children have signs of some inflammation in the gingival tissue of the neck of the teeth. Okay, so among adults, the initial stage of the gum disease is prevalent and this condition is termed gingivitis. Okay, and it is characterized by redness of the gum margin, swelling, bleeding on brushing. So this is about gingivitis and it is also a periodontal disease. Okay, and periodontitis, when periodontal disease affects the bone and the supporting tissue, so it is termed as periodontitis and it is characterized by the formation of pockets or spaces between tooth and gums. Okay, so what are the symptoms of this periodontal diseases? Swollen or puffy gums, bright red, dusky red color gums, and gums that feel tender when on touching. Okay, gums that bleed very easily. Okay, gums that pull away from your teeth, making your teeth look longer as normal, no? And new spaces developing between your teeth, and painful chewing. When you chew some food, it little pains. So these are the symptoms. These are the common symptoms of periodontal diseases. So prevention. Prevention is proper hygiene of teeth, brushing properly on a regular basis, regular dental checkups, and professional teeth cleaning as required. Okay. The drugs basically which are prescribed in this condition, tetracycline, doxycycline. So these are the drugs. Okay. Next disease we will move is trench mouth. Trench mouth, it is a severe gum infection basically caused by buildup of the bacteria and it is caused by Prevotella fusobacterium species, Treponema vincetin. Okay, so this is generally occur in the patients which are infected by in HIV infected patients. Okay, so this is very serious disease, trench mouth. Causes of trench mouth. What are the causes? See, what we are observing for every common disease of oral cavity, we are first observing the cause of poor dental hygiene. So it is the main cause for all the diseases. So poor dental hygiene. Okay, poor nutrition, smoking, stress, infection in the mouth, HIV and AIDS. Okay, diabetes in very serious cases, trench mouth. Symptoms, bad breath or bad taste in the mouth and bleeding in response to irritation or the pressure, ulcer in the mouth, fatigue, fever, grayish film of the gum and gums that are red, swollen, bleeding gums. Okay, pain in the gums. So these are the symptoms of trench mouth. Treatment part. The treatment part is antibiotics to stop the infection. Okay, to stop the infection from spreading further. So amoxicillin, okay, clindamycin and doxycycline. These are commonly prescribed. Okay, and this treatment depends based on the severity of the condition of the patient. Pain relievers generally we give when there is a pain. So of course pain relievers are prescribed. Professional cleaning from the dental dentist and proper ongoing on proper oral hygiene. Okay, so this is the treatment of trench mouth. Moving to next is thrush. Thrush is the immune system of the body's normal bacteria keep using candida in balance. So when this balance is interrupted, okay, so this can result in the overgrowth of candida fungus causing thrush. Prevention is brushing regularly. See, as I said, major causes you have to, or we have to, always maintain our dental hygiene properly. Okay, so prevention, brushing regularly, cleaning denture and attending dental appointments regularly, keeping diabetes in control, okay, and stopping smoking. So these are some preventive measures for thrush. Okay, now the treatment. Antibiotic treatment is given fluconazole, cotrimazole, lozenges, and itraconazole, which is the oral antifungal drugs which are generally prescribed under this condition, and amphotericin B, which is a drug which is used to treat the severe infection. So these are few antibiotics, and as I said, thus it may depend on the condition of the patient. Okay, next is dry mouth. Okay, dry mouth, it causes due to the decrease in the saliva. When there is the less production of saliva in the mouth, it results in the one dental condition, oral cavities condition, that is dryness in the mouth. So dry mouth is often due to the side effects of the certain medications also, or aging issues as a result of as a result of the radiation therapy in case of cancer patient. So what are the causes? Causes are medications. If we take certain medicines which results in the dry mouth as a side effect, okay, aging and cancer therapy, when the cancer patient goes in the chemotherapy sessions, so as a result of a side effect, the patient may feel dryness in the mouth, nerve damage, okay, and other health conditions. Okay, so these are few causes of dry mouth. Symptoms: dryness, feeling in the mouth, okay, as you are, the patient is thirsty, okay, saliva that deems chicken stingy, bad breath, okay, difficulty in chewing, dry or sore throat, okay, dry or group tongue, okay, and a change in the sense of taste. So these are few symptoms of dry mouth. Treatment, okay, pilocarpine and sevimelin, these are two prescription drugs for dry mouth that reduces the symptoms of dry mouth and increase the production of secretion for few hours. It increases the salivary secretion. Flossing and brushing teeth with a fluoride containing toothpaste, decreasing the intake of carbohydrate that stick, such as cookies, bread, potatoes, chips. Okay, so this is the symptom for dry mouth. Next is herpetic gingivostomatitis. Okay, so herpetic gingivostomatitis is a viral infection of the oral mucous membrane caused by herpes simplex virus. Okay, so symptoms are high fever and irritability, anorexia and soreness in the mouth, lesions, formations, not able to chew or swallow. The patient is not able to chew or swallow. General discomfort and uneasiness or ill feeling. The patient has ill feeling and bad breath. So these are few symptoms of herpetic gingivostomatitis. Okay, treatment is, it includes the large quantity of fluid intake, okay, good oral hygiene, okay, gentle debridement of mouth, and the drugs like acyclovir and famciclovir, valacyclovir. So these are the drugs which are used for this problem. Okay, next is mumps. So this, you may be familiar of mumps. Mumps is a contagious disease caused by a virus that passes from one person to another person through saliva and nasal secretions, and if the person which is in the close contact with the persons having the same problem. The condition primarily it affects the salivary glands, and also it calls as a parotid glands. So these glands are responsible for producing saliva basically, and there are three sets of the salivary gland on each side of your face, located behind and below the ears. So mumps, if we generally notice in few kids, so mumps, the symptoms of mumps are fatigue, tiredness, weakness, and body acne, headache, a loss of appetite, low grade fever we observe in this condition, muscle pain, and painful swelling of usually both, sometimes only in one parotid salivary glands. Okay, so these are the symptoms of mumps. Next is the prevention of mumps. The most common preventive measure for mumps is the vaccination with the mumps. So the vaccine may be given separately or as a part of MMR immunization vaccine, which is a that also protects against measles and rubella. Okay, the MMR vaccine, which generally protects us from measles and rubella, it is also helpful. Okay, and may be given separately. All right. Treatment of mumps. So treatment part is antipyretics. Okay, acetaminophen and ibuprofen are indicated for fever. If the patient is having mumps and feeling the fever, so this drug is prescribed. Mumps arthritis may respond in 2 week course of the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents like corticosteroids. Okay, bed rest is suggested to the patient, and diet should be adjusted according to the patient's ability to chew. So this is only the treatment for mumps. Okay, mouth ulcer. Mouth ulcer, it is also known as canker sores, which are normally small painful lesions that develop the mouth or at a base of your gums. So minor canker sores are small oval or round ulcer that heal within 1 or 2 weeks with no scarring, and major canker sores are larger and deeper, and minor ones sometimes they have irregular edges and can take up to 6 weeks to heal. So herpetiform canker sores are pinpoint size occurs in clusters of 10 to hundreds. Okay, and often affects the adults. So this is a mouth ulcer. So as you can see in this figure, the development of the ulcer in the beneath the layer of lips. Causes of mouth ulcer. See, what are the causes of mouth ulcer? See, minor mouth ulcer injury from dental work or hard brushing, sports injury or accidental bites, it may result in mouth ulcer. Lack of essential vitamins. So this is very important. If we lack some vitamin in our diet, so it may lead to mouth ulcer, especially vitamin B12, folate and iron. Alright, so allergic response to the mouth bacteria, dental brushes, hormonal changes during menstruation, and emotional stress, lack of sleep, and bacterial, viral, and fungal infection. So these are few causes of development of mouth ulcer. So moving to the treatment part. So what is the treatment? Using a rinse of salt water and baking soda. Okay, that's good. So dear students, remember the treatment, the homemade treatment of mouth ulcer is rinse your mouth with the salt water and baking soda, placing milk of magnesia on the mouth ulcer, okay, covering mouth ulcer with baking soda paste, and using OTC benzocaine product, okay, which is available on the chemist shop. Benzocaine gel form it comes. It's a topical anesthesia basically. So the symptoms of mouth ulcers, like the little burning sensation when the mouth ulcer is exposed to the salivary part, saliva of the oral cavity, so then there you feel a little burning sensation. Okay, so benzocaine local anesthesia anesthetic product, it is applied and ice, and applying ice to canker sores, and using a mouth rinse that contains a steroids to reduce the pain and swelling. Okay, taking nutritional supplements like folic acid, vitamin B6, vitamin B12 supplements. So these are the treatment of mouth ulcer. Tooth erosion. See, tooth erosion is defined as irreversible loss of tooth structure. Irreversible loss of tooth structure due to the chemical dissolution by acid or the acid by acid not of bacterial origin. The most common cause of erosion is by acidic food and drinks. So in general, foods that bring foods and drinks below pH of 5 to 5.7 have been known to trigger the dental erosion effects. Okay, if we drink any food, if we eat any food, or if we drink anything which has pH from 5 to 5.7 for a long period of time, then this problem may happen. Okay, tooth erosion. Causes of tooth erosion: accumulation of food particles, accumulation of bacteria in gelatinous mass, which is called plaque. Okay, aerobic fermentation of sugar in anaerobic fermentation of sugar in saliva, and release of lactic acid, and sensation occur due to the erosion of teeth by lactic acid. So these are few causes of tooth erosion. Okay, next disease of oral cavity is staining in the teeth, which is very common. Stained teeth can become the teeth becomes discolored by stains on the surface by change inside the tooth. So there are three main type of tooth discoloration. Extrinsic, this occurs when the outer layer of the tooth, that is the enamel part, is stained, like coffee, tobacco, by the use of wine, cola and other drinks and food, that may develop this kind of discoloring in your teeth. Intrinsic, when the inner structure of the tooth is affected or it becomes darkened. And third is age related. Okay, third is age related. So this is a combination of extrinsic and intrinsic factor. Okay, it may develop in the any like age related it is, and it is a combination of both the things. The enamel that covers the teeth that gets thinner with the age, which allows the dentin to show through, and food and smoking can stain the teeth, the people of elderly age people. Okay, cavities, which is very common. Cavity also called as tooth decay. This cavity, we also discuss this cavity in the beginning, that cavity which is one of the disease of oral cavity. So I'll just skip this slide. Okay, okay, now moving to hyperodontia. This is developing an extra teeth. So hyperodontia is a condition of having supernumerary teeth. Supernumerary teeth are the teeth that appear in addition to the regular number of teeth. Okay, they can appear in any area of the dental arc and can affect the dental organs. Okay, so this is hyperdontia. Okay, types. Supernumerary teeth can be classified by shape and by its position in the oral cavity. So, supplemental, where the tooth has a normal shape for the teeth, that in series, and tuberculate, conial, and the compound odontoma and complex odontoma. So, these are types of hyperdontia. Causes, genetic factor. The prime cause of hyperdontia, that the development of extra teeth in your oral cavity, the main cause is genetic factor, environmental factor, and overactivity of dental lamina during tooth development. And what is the treatment to detect? First, evaluate and treat supernumerary teeth as soon as possible, since the additional teeth will present both cosmetic as well as functional problem for the affected individual. Okay. Next is next and the last disease of our oral cavity is mal occlusion. Mal occlusion is a misalignment, or it is incorrect relation between the teeth of the two dental arc when they approach each other as the jaw close. Okay, causes of this is often present at the birth and can manifest as a space between the teeth. So, irregular jaw or the mouth size. Okay, and it can be acquired from habits such as thumb sucking by the kids and tongue thrusting, premature loss of teeth from an accident or the dental disease. So, these are the common causes of mal occlusion. What is the treatment of the mal occlusion? Devices, dentures, braces, and this is the treatment. This is long-term treatment. The patient has to give many sittings to treat this mal occlusion, and personal hygiene, personal cleanliness that promotes the health and well-being. Surgery is the treatment, and the specialist is required to treat such cases. And so this is about mal occlusion. So dear students, till now in this module we have discussed a number of diseases of oral cavity and their causes, prevention, and treatment. So these are the references. Just go through from these references for detailed study, and let us quickly summarize this module. So we have studied in this module different common diseases of oral cavity. Okay, so list of diseases like periodontal diseases we have discussed, and development of extra teeth we have discussed, and there are the tooth decay and discoloration, pigmentation. So all these things we have discussed, the underlying causes of all the diseases, symptoms associated, and the preventive measures and treatment. So dear students, that's all for this module. So I really hope that you have enjoyed this module, and now you will be able to answer the question which in any form will be in any form if it is asked, like the analyst, the different diseases of oral cavity, their causes, prevention, and treatment. Okay, and if it is asked in the examination specifically by mentioning the name of the disease, okay, so then only you'll be able to answer this question. Okay, so dear student, that's all for today, and stay tuned for more modules on cosmetics and cosmeceuticals, and thank you so much for watching this video.